Welcome friends. So today we are going to discuss about introduction of glycolysis. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about the syllabus, which is divided into four units. And out of that four, the first unit was dealing with biomolecules. Second, the enzyme. Third, with the carbohydrate metabolism, and fourth with the lipid and protein metabolism. So today we are dealing with the today we are going to discuss about introduction of glycolysis, which is one of the part of unit third. It is an interesting point, and it is one of the important points. So glycolysis. So the word glycolysis, it is derived from two Greek words, that is glycose, which means sweet or the sugar, and the lysis, that means dissolution or the breakdown. In your syllabus, you know there are two types of words, that is genesis or the lysis. So genesis, that means synthesis, whereas lysis, that means the breakdown. It is universal pathway in the living cells. Glycolysis can be defined as the sequence of reactions which are involved in the conversion of glucose or the glycogen to pyruvate or the lactate with the production of ATP. If the glycolysis process, it is occurring in the presence of oxygen, it is called as aerobic glycolysis, whose end product will be pyruvate, which is also called as the pyruvic acid. Whereas if it is in the absence of oxygen, which is called as the anaerobic glycolysis, its end product will be lactate. Glycolysis, it is also known as EMP pathway, which stands for the name of scientist, that is Embden, Mayrhof, and the Parnas pathway. In glycolysis, there occurs splitting of 6 carbon sugar or the glucose molecule into 2 molecules of 3 carbon pyruvate in a series of steps or the reactions. And each and every reaction, it is catalyzed by a particular enzyme. There are near about 10 reactions, and that each and every reaction has one enzyme, and it is occurring inside the cell cytoplasm. The enzymes are also present within the cell cytoplasm. Glycolysis, the main function or main use of the glycolysis is to get the energy. It produces the energy along with the pyruvate, which is in the form of ATP molecules. So salient features of glycolysis. Students sometimes get confused with the word silent and the salient. So here the word salient. Salient, that means the special features. So special features of the glycolysis, and when we are using the word silent, that means as we always say that please keep the silence, so remain silent. So there is difference in spelling and the pronunciation also of the salient and the silent. Here salient features of the glycolysis. So glycolysis, it is also known as Embden, Mayrhof, Parnas pathway, as it is discovered by the three scientists. The first one, that is Gustav Embden, second one, that is Otto Mayrhof, and the third one, that is Jacob Carol Parnas. It takes place in all the cells of the body. The enzymes of this pathway are present in the cell cytoplasm itself. As we know, glycolysis occurs in the presence or the absence of oxygen. If it is occurring in absence of oxygen, it is called as anaerobic glycolysis. And if it is occurring in the presence of oxygen, it is called as aerobic glycolysis. Depending on the nature, whether it is aerobic or anaerobic, the product will also get changed. So lactate is the end product under anaerobic condition, whereas pyruvate or the pyruvic acid will be the end product in the aerobic condition. Glycolysis is a major pathway for ATP synthesis in tissues like in mitochondria, that is erythrocytes, cornea, and lens, because there are two cycles, the that would be Krebs cycle or the ETS, through which there occurs production of energy, maximum production of energy in the form of ATP. It is through that mitochondria. And if any cell lacks the mitochondria, so at that time glycolysis, it is the major pathway to produce the ATP. It is very essential for the brain, which is dependent on the glucose for energy. Brain cells does not sh they cannot store the glucose, so that's why they are depend on the blood stream for the supply of the glucose. And at the same time, fat or the fatty acids cannot cross that particular or they cannot enter into that brain cells. So that's why glucose, it is the only source of the energy for the brain. And the reverse to the glycolysis, it is the gluconeogenesis, in which there occurs synthesis of that glucose. Here the word it is gluconeogenesis, from the non-carbohydrate sources of carbon. So reactions of glycolysis. The sequence of reactions of glycolysis can be divided into three distinct phases. There are 10 reactions present in the glycolysis. The phases are, the first phase, it is called as energy investment phase or the priming phase. The main purpose of the glycolysis, it is to get the energy, which is in the form of ATP molecule. And the investment, that means in this phase there occurs loss of the ATP molecules. As you know, if we want to earn money through the business, so at that time first we have to invest the money, so which is that investment phase. So like to that, this glycolysis, it has also investment phase, which is consist of first three reactions. Whereas the next one, it is the splitting phase, in which there occurs splitting of one molecule of glucose into two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So it will form two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, and then that each molecule of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate will get converted into the molecule of pyruvate or the pyruvic acid. And during its that particular chain, it will form four ATP molecules. But as we know, it has already we have lost two ATP molecules, so the net production of the ATP molecule, it is only two. And last phase, it is the energy generation phase. I forgot to tell you one thing, the splitting phase, it is consists of two reactions, reaction number four and reaction number five. Whereas energy generation phase, it is consist of last five reaction, in which there occurs formation of ATP molecules. In this phase, there occurs formation of or production of four ATP molecules. Two molecules, that means as you know, glycolysis, it has during the splitting phase, it has formed two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, and then that each and every molecule will get converted into the pyruvate. So during its conversion, it will form one molecule will form two molecules of ATP. And as we have two molecules of that particular glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, so it will produce four molecules of ATP. And during the investment phase, we have lost two, so net production of ATP molecule in glycolysis it is two. In addition to that particular ATP molecule, it also forms the pyruvate and the NADH. So pyruvate it will enter into the that phase cycle, which will again produce the ATP molecule, where that NADH it will enter into the ETS, where there it also it will again produce the ATP molecules. So on the last segment, that is recap. So what we learned during this particular lecture, we have learned about the definition. Simply, glycolysis means the splitting of the glucose into pyruvate. The glucose, it is six carbon compound. As we know, its chemical formula is C6H12O6, and that pyruvate or the pyruvic acid, it is made up of three molecule. So due to the splitting, due to the breakdown of the glucose, it will form two molecules of pyruvate or the pyruvic acid in the sequence of the reactions, and the number of reactions it is 10. We also get an idea that what an idea that it is also called as the EMP, that is Embiddon Mayer Parnas pathway, depending on the name of scientist who discovered this particular glycolysis. We also discuss about the salient features, that means it occurs in that particular cell cytoplasm. Each and every reaction, it is under the control of any type of enzyme. So these are some salient feature. And the last one, that is the types of reactions, that is the investment phase, splitting phase, and the energy generation phase. In investment phase, there occurs loss of two ATP molecules, which is belonging to the first three reactions out of 10. The second, that is splitting, in this there occurs formation of three carbon molecule, that is glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, from that glucose. And this particular phase, it is consist of the reaction number 4 and 5. And the last, that is energy generation phase, in which there occurs production of ATP molecules. The net production of ATP molecules, it is 2, which is from the reaction number 6 to 10. So it is up to introduction of glycolysis.